Okay, guys, now we are going to start the next topic, that is dealing with model analysis by principles of similarity. So the principles of similarity is very simple thing. If the Buckingham Pi theorem is clear to you, why we do dimension analysis, if it is clear to you, then principles of similarity will be very, very easy for you. Okay, so already we know to do the model testing for big size components, like a case of ship or a submarine or a dam or a airplane, this kind of big or any kind of big size turbo machinery, we should prepare a model, just replica of those prototype, and doing some real time experiment based on that model, we should try to realize that what are the problems will be faced, what are the forces will be faced by that particular real time prototype. That's why this kind of model analysis is very, very, very important for this fluid mechanics subject. Okay, so not only in fluid mechanics subject, and in case of any kind of big size design like strength of material subject, also this kind of model analysis, you know, is followed there. So that way, if you want to prepare a model in just a replica of that particular prototype, then we have to follow these principles of similarity. I'm writing over here some point, like by dimensional analysis, we can describe a problem by a functional relationship between non-dimensional parameters, that is pi1, pi2, pi3, dot dot dot, pi4, pi5. Already I have done all these things. We can describe any real-time problem by using these non-dimensional parameters. We know. Then if you want to achieve the full similarity means all kinds of similarity between model and prototype. If it is not followed, then if any similarity we missed, then that issue or that particular parameter will create a very critical problem for real-time problem or real-time prototype. That's why full similarity, all kinds of similarity should be maintained between this model and prototype. I am repeating, similarity, they are not same. Similarity and same, they are different, because if you want to follow similarity, some ratio should be equal with the model and prototype. That means, suppose length of prototype and the length of model, they will be coming with a particular scale. Velocities will be in a particular ratio in terms of model and prototype. But velocity of the model and the velocity of the prototype, they won't be equal, because for a small size model, it won't be achievable to create that kind of real-time plane. Suppose if you are creating a model of a submarine, so that submarine will having a drag force. Model of the submarine will obviously having a drag force, but it will not be a same value whatever it is filled by the real submarine, because in real manner that kind of drag force can't be created by a small size model. But it should be, similarity should be there. But that means there must be some ratios. It will be some maintained with some proper scale. That's why I have written over here. Then full similarity requires these parameters must be same at both prototype and model by using some proper scale. Proper scale must be there. Suppose 1:5, 1:10, 1:20 scale will be there if the model is smaller and the prototype is bigger. Reverse thing also can be done. If the real-time scenario is very small, suppose a kind of a nano tube, some micro-size element is flowing through nano tube, that point of time we should create a bigger size model. So that point of time some enlarging scale will be used, but scale must be there. So just to achieve the full similarity, this functional relationship should be equal in between model and prototype. That's why I have written over here, pi1m for model equals to pi1p for prototype. Similarly, pi2 function, pi2m equals to pi2p. If there is 4, 5 or 6 pi functions, they all will be equal with the prototype. The similarities can be maintained by these three types. Geometric similarity, kinematic similarity and dynamic similarity always should be maintained. Geometric similarity, all know, some length parameters like diameter, like volume. Kinematic similarity, we all know, it's dealing with the velocity, acceleration, and dynamic similarity, we all know, with some force, inertia force, viscous force, surface tension force, Okay, so these similar three categories basically we have to follow always. Now one thing should be keep in your mind that if we follow the dynamic similarity, then geometric similarity and kinematic similarity already will be followed by the prototype. Because if we want to achieve the dynamic similarity, then geometric similarity or kinematic similarity must be followed. Matlab, अगर जियोमेट्रिक और काइनेमेटिक सिमिलरिटी फॉलो नहीं होगा तो डायनामिक सिमिलरिटी मेंटेन करना नामुमकिन है. सो इफ वी मेंटेन द डायनामिक सिमिलरिटी बिटवीन मॉडल एंड प्रोटोटाइप, सो ऑब्वियसली फ्रॉम द बैक स्टेज वी कैन से द जियोमेट्रिक एंड काइनेमेटिक सिमिलरिटी ऑलरेडी बीइंग फॉलोड बिटवीन मॉडल एंड प्रोटोटाइप. ओके, सो बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द सिमिलरिटी यूजिंग सम न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम, सो वी शुड express some dimensionless number. Dimensionless numbers are very important. Dimensionless numbers. Why they are so important? Because this dimensionless number will be used to express lots of flow parameters or flow types or using those dimensionless parameter numbers like Reynolds number, Froude's number, Mach number. I'm going to express them. Each of them having some important role in fluid field or fluid mechanics field. So in heat transfer subject also we are going to deal with lots of dimensionless number, but I am going to elaborate over here some dimensionless number which are basically very closely connected with fluid mechanics subject. Suppose first one, all these dimensionless number, they are basically ratio between some forces. Okay, so first one I have written pressure force to inertia force. So pressure force, we know it is nothing but the pressure multiplied with the area. Suppose if I note it by change of pressure or differential pressure, that is del P multiplied with L square. I am going to write all this thing in terms of either dynamic term or geometric term or kinematic term. Okay. So del P into L square denoting basically area. Area means meter square or length square. So del P into L square, that is basically pressure force. Now coming to inertia force. Inertia force is nothing but the force which is responsible for motion. That is Newton's law of motion. Mass into acceleration. So mass we can write that density into L cube. Isn't it? Density comes with kg per meter cube. And if it is multiplied with L cube, so it will give you mass. And acceleration you can write it like u into du dx. Acceleration can be written like this. Okay, so u into du dx, that term I can write it like this, u square by L, isn't it? Because the du nothing but velocity. So velocity square, and dx is nothing but distance. That's why it is expressed by L. Okay, so that way that inertia force I can write in this manner. That is nothing but rho L cube, that is mass into acceleration u square by L. So what I ultimately giving you, L cube and L square, it will be cancelled. So rho L square u square. Okay, so that will be giving you finally inertia force. That should be keep in your mind. It will be used several times now. So inertia force will be expressed by rho into L square into u square. So finally L square will be cancelled and it will be giving you change of pressure divided by rho into u square. Okay. So is it unitless? Obviously it should be unitless. If there is any confusion, you can check it. I can show you one time. Otherwise, afterwards, I am going to express lots of number. You check them. Are they coming dimensionless or not? So, pressure is coming with a unit of Newton per meter square. Density is coming with kg per meter cube. Meter cube upar utha diya. And u square is coming with meter square per second square. Okay, now that Newton is nothing but kg meter per second square, तो second square नीचे डाल दिए, तो ये सेकंड स्क्वायर कैंसिल हो जाएगा, केजी केजी कैंसिल हो जाएगा, मीटर टू द पावर 4 आ गया, मीटर टू द पावर 4 आ गया, तो ये मीटर टू द पावर 4 भी कैंसिल्ड हो जाएगा. सो ऑलवेज दिस नंबर्स आर डायमेंशनलेस. इफ देयर इज एनी कंफ्यूजन इन योर माइंड, सो चेक देम, इज इट डायमेंशनलेस और नॉट. एंड दिस रेशियो इज नोन एज ऑयलर्स नंबर. सो ऑयलर्स नंबर, इट इज द रेशियो बिटवीन प्रेशर फोर्स टू इनर्शिया फोर्स, एंड इट इज एक्सप्रेस बाय चेंज ऑफ प्रेशर divided by rho u square. Okay, so it is Euler's number is very important in case of fluid dynamics. If there is any flow occurring due to the pressure difference, some forces are acting over there like inertia force or viscous force, that point of time that Euler's number is very important. So it will come for you afterwards. Now if we are going to show you some more numbers, like second one I am going to explain, that is a ratio between inertia force to inertia force to surface tension force. So inertia force already I have expressed by rho L square u square. Rho L square u square, we have already expressed inertia force by this term. And surface tension force is nothing but, we know the unit of surface tension, that is newton meter. Surface tension ka jo unit hota hai, jo surface tension ka jo unit hota tha, wo basically newton per meter mein hota tha. Theek hai, तो न्यूटन पर मीटर को अगर तुम एक मीटर से मल्टीप्लाई कर दोगे तो वो आ जाएगा न्यूटन, दैट इज द फोर्स. सो बेसिकली सिग्मा इनटू अगर एल कर देते हो तो दैट विल गिव यू अ सरफेस टेंशन फोर्स, बिकॉज दैट सरफेस टेंशन दैट इज सिग्मा कम्स विद द यूनिट ऑफ सिग्मा इज कम्स विद द यूनिट ऑफ न्यूटन मीटर, सॉरी न्यूटन पर मीटर, नॉट न्यूटन मीटर. न्यूटन मीटर इज एनर्जी, न्यूटन पर मीटर. एंड इफ इट इज मल्टीप्लाइड विद एन मीटर देन इट विल गिव यू अ न्यूटन, दैट इज अ फोर्स. That way, that surface tension force can be written sigma into L. So finally, L will be cancelled. It will giving you rho u square L by sigma. Okay, this number is known as Weber number. Weber number. This Weber number is important also basically in case of flowing fluid. One fluid is flowing through another fluid, two immiscible fluids are flowing. So in between that immiscible surface tension will act over there. That point of time, this Weber number comes into action or comes into picture. Then number three, put inertia force. Inertia, I'm omitting that force term repeatedly, okay. By surface tension force. Inertia force to surface tension force. You should write force over here. Yeah? So inertia force to surface Weber's number I have completed. Then I am going another one, inertia force to gravity force. Gravity force. These numbers are very important, mind it. So inertia force we already expressed by rho L square u square. And gravity force is nothing but mg, very easy. So that way, m into g, m ko hum log intentionally likhenge, pehle bhi likhe hain, waise hi likhenge, rho into l cube, kg per meter cube into meter cube, so it will giving you again mass. So rho cancelled ho jayega, ek l niche reh jayega, so you are getting u square by gl. Okay. Now, from here, I can get another number, that is Froude number, a Froude number. Froude number. Froude number is root over of this term, u square by gl. You can check this thing. You can check this number, is it unitless or not? You can check it, huh? You also can check it, is it unitless or not? All they will be unitless. If you are not making any mistake, they will be unitless. So, this root over of all these whole expression is known as Froude number, and Froude number generally expressed by F E and it can be written like u root over g into l. L is a characteristic length. It can be d for circular path. If it is a pipe, then it will be diameter. If it is a channel, then it will be length. Okay, and u is a velocity. So this Froude number is very important for any kind of channel flow. Suppose the flow pattern, is it a critical flow or it is a subcritical or supercritical, that is basically expressed by this Froude number. It will come with you for the next semester, fluid advanced fluid subject. That point of time, this Froude number, you can see, will be very important for you to find out hydraulic jump. It will come later. Then the next ratio I am coming with, inertia force to elastic force. Elastic force, you are familiar in strength of material subject, that is modulus of elasticity. Okay, ratio of stress to strength, that thing. Inertia force, already you are using rho L square U square, and elastic force is nothing but modulus of elasticity. Modulus of elasticity is coming with a unit of Newton per meter square, I think you know. And if it is multiplied with L square, so again m square, so it will give you Newton. That's why E into L square. Okay, mind it, E is modulus of elasticity. So that way it is coming U square, L square, L square will be cancelled by E by rho. I'm writing in this fashion intentionally because that E by rho, this term, or rather say root over E by rho, it is nothing but sonic velocity. Sonic velocity through any medium. Sonic velocity means the velocity of sound. Okay. So that way, that ratio, that number is known as Mach number. It is written by AMA, and Mach number is basically root over of all those things, root over of U square, and this root over E by rho, that is basically sonic velocity, is generally it is expressed by A. Okay, the sonic velocity is generally expressed by A. So if root over E by rho equals to A, then E by rho equals to A square, isn't it? So Mach number is nothing but U by A. U is the velocity of that particular particle and A is the velocity of sound through the medium. And if it is through air, then the velocity of sound is 330 meter per second. Sound velocity through air. If the medium is changed from air to any other medium, obviously sonic velocity obviously will be getting changed. And U is the velocity of the particular element. Okay, Mach number is very important to know, is the flow nature of the particular flow, is it sonic or it is a supersonic or subsonic. Greater than 1, less than 1 or equals to 1, depending on that, the flow can be subsonic, supersonic or only sonic. It is also very important and it will also come in your next semester with advanced fluid subject, advanced fluid mechanics subject. Okay, and we also left with another number, that is, now the next one is Mach number ke baad aata hai viscous force to surface tension force. Fifth number, viscous force to surface tension. So viscous force is nothing but, it can be expressed by tau equals to mu du dy. You know that thing, isn't it? So mu is equals to, we can write that viscous force is nothing but shear stress into area.
because due to viscosity that shear stress will be developed. So shear stress multiplied with area, that will giving a force, and that force is known as viscous force. So tau is nothing but mu into du dy, and that will be multiplied with area. Area means L square, isn't it? So that way, that viscous force is inertia force, viscous force to inertia force, yeah. So that way, that viscous force is represented by mu u by L. L, that means dy. Dy is nothing but the distance. Distance is expressed by L into L square. That is the viscous force. Is it clear to you or not? If it is not clear, then reply to me. Okay. So, mu u by L, L means for dy into L square. That will be giving a viscous force, and surface tension force already we know, sigma into L. Okay, this L and this L square will be cancelled, and that L also will be cancelled. So that way it is giving mu into u by sigma. And that number is known as capillary number. Capillary number. Basically, due to surface tension phenomenon, that capillary number is very important when viscous drag force or viscous drag force versus surface tension force acting between two immiscible liquid. In between two immiscible liquid, these two forces, surface tension force and viscous force, will be coming over there. That point of time, that capillary number will comes into picture. And one more number is left out over there. That is nothing but the inertia force to viscous force. It is very common to us. Inertia force to viscous force. That is known as Reynolds number. So inertia force we already know, that is rho L square by U square. And viscous force already we have find out, mu into U into L. Mu into U into L. So that way it will give you, one U will be cancelled, one L will be cancelled. So rho U into L by mu. So that is known as Reynolds number. Now one thing you can see over here. Is it visible? Sorry. Now it is visible. Sorry. Rho into U into L by mu equals to Reynolds number. Now you people already know the Reynolds number like this manner. Check it. Rho V D by mu. You are very familiar with this form. Now mind it, Baba. If you are considering a pipe, then take this D. And if you are considering a channel, then you have to consider this L. Because this D or L, that is the basically characteristic term, characteristic length. So characteristic length, obviously, it won't be same for all kind of flow nature. If it is a flowing through a pipeline, then it will be diameter of the pipe. If it is flowing through a channel, then how you can consider a diameter of channel? That point of time, you have to consider the length of that particular channel. So that's why keep it in your mind that always rho Vd by mu will be taken for any kind of flow pattern. Not so. Because this particular thing is basically characteristic length. Characteristic length depends on the flow path. Okay. So these numberless, dimensionless numbers are very important. I have shown you 6 dimensionless number, and they will be facing you in this particular fluid mechanics subject in this semester or afterwards it will come for you. Next video we are going to start some problem dealing with principles of similarity. Okay guys, now it's a problem dealing with dimensional analysis as well as it is connected with the principles of similarity. Okay. Problem statement, this whole page is a problem statement. So don't get afraid. It's a simple thing. Statement will be bigger, but the problem will be very, very easy. Okay. Statement is look like this. A prototype gate valve. Gate valve, you know, for any kind of fluid flow through a pipeline, a kind of gate valve, basically by rotating the wheel, the supply will be shut off or it can be regulated. Okay, you can using that kind of valve for your home servant purpose also. Domestic purpose, you're using the gate valve. It's a kind of wheel can be regulated from the top. Okay, it can be very bigger in size.
It can be a smaller in our domestic purpose, but it is very, very bigger in size in kind of irrigation size type. Okay. So a prototype gate valve, prototype means it's a real-time gate valve, which will control the flow in a pipe system conveying paraffin. Paraffin is a fluid, a liquid which is basically lighter than water. Conveying paraffin is to be started in a model. Now to prepare a model with a particular gate valve. In real manner, the prototype is having a flow of paraffin, but in model, it can be done by paraffin also, but see what the fluid is using in model. Let's see. The pressure drop depends. Pressure drop means the gate valve ke left side or right side mein pressure drop to hona hi chahiye. Nahi to pressure drop agar nahi hoga to koi bhi fluid flow nahi ho payega. So the pressure drop depends on gate opening. That means the valve ka jo tum wheel ghumate ho, isse gate ka opening badhta hai. अगर एंटी क्लॉकवाइज घुमाओगे तो गेट ओपनिंग बढ़ेगा, क्लॉकवाइज घुमाओगे तो गेट ओपनिंग कम होगा. सो रेगुलेटिंग दैट गेट ओपनिंग यू कैन चेंज द प्रेशर डिफरेंस. ओके, सो द प्रेशर ड्रॉप डिपेंड्स ऑन व्हिच पैरामीटर दे आर गिवन. गेट ओपनिंग दैट इज एक्सप्रेस बाय एच, ओवरऑल डेप्थ दैट मीन्स द डेप्थ ऑफ द फ्लूइड दैट इज एक्सप्रेस बाय डी, वेलोसिटी ऑफ फ्लो ऑफ फ्लूइड दैट इज वी, डेंसिटी ऑफ फ्लूइड दैट इज रो, विस्कोसिटी ऑफ फ्लूइड दैट इज म्यू. So all these are relevant variables on which the pressure drop depends. Okay. Now perform dimensional analysis to obtain the relevant non-dimensional group. Up to this part there is nothing exceptional to explain. But just you have to using the Buckingham Pi theorem and build those dimensionless functions. Pi 1, Pi 2 or Pi 3. Okay. Then from here, we are going to enter in the similarity part, from here, similarity analysis. Now, it has been told you that a 1:5 scale model is built to determine the pressure drop across the valve with water as the working fluid. I mentioned you that the model can be used paraffin also, but you are using water as the working fluid for model. And here two very important thing is given, 1:5 scale. That means length scale between prototype and model will be 1:5. If the prototype is 5, then the model will be 1. Length scale. Okay, that means I can write it like this manner. LM, writing over here. LM is to LP. Or rather say LM by LP. It will be 5. It will be 1 by 5. Okay. That is, model will be smaller. How many times of model smaller? 5 times smaller than the prototype. Okay. Now, A mein ek asking likha hai. Kya hai? Ki for a particular opening of the gate valve, when the velocity of paraffin in the prototype is 3 meter per second. That means, velocity of the paraffin means prototype mein पैराफिन का जो फ्लो होगा वो 3 मीटर पर सेकेंड एक पर्टिकुलर गेट ओपनिंग के लिए. व्हाट शुड बी द वेलोसिटी ऑफ वाटर इन द मॉडल फॉर डायनामिक सिमिलरिटी. डायनामिक सिमिलरिटी अगर मेंटेन करोगे तो वेलोसिटी ऑफ वाटर क्या होगा जब पैराफिन का वेलोसिटी 3 मीटर पर सेकेंड होगा. सेकेंड आस्किंग है, व्हाट इज द रेशियो ऑफ द क्वांटिटीज ऑफ फ्लो. क्वांटिटीज ऑफ फ्लो मीन्स डिस्चार्ज, नथिंग बट इन प्रोटोटाइप एंड मॉडल. प्रोटोटाइप और मॉडल में ये डिस्चार्ज का रेशियो क्या होगा, मतलब QM टू QP. फाइंड द प्रेशर ड्रॉप इन प्रोटोटाइप. प्रेशर ड्रॉप ढूंढना है, दैट मीन्स डेल पी. इफ इट इज 60 kPa इन द मॉडल, मॉडल में प्रेशर ड्रॉप दे दिया है 60 kPa, यू हैव टू फाइंड इट फॉर द मॉडल. दीज आर द ABC यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट यूजिंग द सिमिलरिटी पार्ट, प्रिंसिपल ऑफ सिमिलरिटी. And the before part is just belongs to the dimensional analysis using the Buckingham Pi theorem. So Buckingham Pi theorem already we are familiar with the process. So we are not going to elaborate that Buckingham Pi theorem again. Just giving you a shortcut method. You have to do it with your own effort. Do the dimensional analysis and build the functions. I can give you some hint that follow the same procedure like step 1, step 2, step 3. First you have to choose the relevant variables. Relevant variables are del P, change of pressure or differential pressure, then H,
then D, then V, then rho, then mu. These are the relevant variables. That means N. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then you have to find the M. That means independent variables. Independent variables, if they are N, then M will be 3. Choose what are the M we are going to choose. One will be geometric, one will be kinematic, one will be dynamic. So you can select D as a dimension, geometric similarity maintain karte hue, ek V le lo, aur ek rho bhi le sakte ho, mu bhi le sakte ho, koi bhi le sakte ho, koi D ki jagah H bhi le sakta hai, theek hai? To alag alag student agar alag alag combination leke karega, to achha hoga. Ek combination ho sakta hai aisa, main combination likh deta ho. Ek combination ho sakta hai M ka aisa, D, V, रो. एक कॉम्बिनेशन ऐसा हो सकता है, एक कॉम्बिनेशन ऐसा भी हो सकता है H. H भी बेसिकली, H किसको लिखा था, गेट ओपनिंग. गेट ओपनिंग भी बेसिकली लेंथ पैरामीटर में ही होगा, मिलीमीटर में या सेंटीमीटर में, ठीक है? या ओवरऑल डेप्थ जो है ये भी लेंथ स्केल में होगा. तो H भी ले सकता है, D भी ले सकता है. ये D मतलब ओवरऑल डेप्थ, ये भी लेंथ स्केल में है. तो H ले लो, V लो और म्यू लो, ये भी एक कॉम्बिनेशन हो सकता है M का. तो अलग अलग स्टूडेंट अलग अलग कॉम्बिनेशन से करोगे तो प्रॉब्लम कुछ नहीं होगा. जस्ट डू द सेम, फॉलो द सेम प्रोसीजर एंड चेक आफ्टरवर्ड्स एट द फिनिशिंग पार्ट एट आर द फंक्शंस आर व्हाट आर यू आर डेवलपिंग आर द डायमेंशनलेस और नॉट. ओके, सो आई हैव सॉल्व दैट प्रॉब्लम बाय टेकिंग दैट पर्टिकुलर कॉम्बिनेशन. सो एनी वन ऑफ यू यू कैन चेक विद दिस कॉम्बिनेशन ऑल्सो. ओके, सो बाय दिस कॉम्बिनेशन I have generated pi 1, you have to do it with your own effort. Huh? I am giving the result over here. So pi 1 is coming like a function of del p d by mu into v. That pi 1 I am getting, then pi 2 I am getting h by d. Obviously it will be h by d, because if h is a term in a unit of length, then d is also a unit of length. And lengthless will be cancelled, it will be a unitless. And pi 3, it will be coming with a unit of Reynolds number, function of Reynolds number, rho vd by mu. Okay, that is nothing but Reynolds number. So I have done with this combination. You can go with this combination also, and you can check what are the functions you are getting with pi 1, pi 2 and pi 3. If they are dimensionless, then it is very right. Okay, so after getting these functions, you can write that pi 1 is a function of pi 2 and pi 3. So that way I can write that del p into d by mu into v, it is a function of h by d comma rho vd by mu. So up to this you have to solve with your own copy and pen and check with these two other combination, and if the functions are dimensionless, you are very correct. So up to this you have to do it your own. Now I am going to show you that what will be the process for A, B and C. A means पूछा है कि तुम्हें dynamic similarity maintain करके तुम्हें velocity of water निकालना है for the model. डायनामिक सिमिलरिटी मैंने पहले ही बोला है कि डायनामिक सिमिलरिटी अगर तुम्हें मेंटेन करना होगा तो जितना भी तुम्हें फंक्शन मिला है सभी फंक्शन में सिमिलरिटी मेंटेन होगा ही होगा, नहीं तो डायनामिक सिमिलरिटी मेंटेन नहीं होगा. डायनामिक सिमिलरिटी मेंटेन करने के लिए ज्योमेट्रिक सिमिलरिटी, काइनेमेटिक सिमिलरिटी मेंटेन करना ही होगा. सो दैट्स व्हाई जस्ट टू फॉर द सेक ऑफ डायनामिक सिमिलरिटी वी कैन राइट पाई वन एम मस्ट बी इक्वल विथ पाई वन प्रोटोटाइप. Then pi 2 m also will be equal with pi 2 prototype, and similarly pi 3 m must be equal with pi 3 prototype. Why they are so? For the sake of dynamic similarity. Okay, if dynamic similarity is maintained, then obviously these three functions will be in a same value in between model and prototype. Now if we choose this particular function pi 3, why I am choosing that one? Because in pi 3 you can very easily you can get the velocity of the model, because rest of the terms, that is rho d mu, will be given to you already in problem statement. That's why I'm taking this pi 3 parameter. I can write it like this: rho m vm dm by mu m is equals with prototype. So rho p vp dp by mu p. I have just used this particular function, pi 3 function. M stands for model, p stands for prototype, nothing else. Now you can see over here that most of the informations are given over here, that is rho p, that is given in the problem. Rho p, that means density of the prototype fluid, that is the paraffin. It is given, the paraffin density and paraffin viscosity, both are given. Okay, paraffin viscosity and paraffin density, both are given. That means prototype viscosity or prototype density, both are known to you. Okay, now one scale is being given, that is 1:5. So 1:5, it is a obviously length scale. So length scale, I can write it. If LM by LP equals to 1/5, obviously length scale may DM by DP also giving you the same result, 1/5, because there is a length scale. तो लेंथ स्केल में अगर 1:5 होगा, कोई भी लेंथ स्केल 1:5 में आना ही होगा, नहीं तो सिमिलरिटी मेंटेन नहीं होगा, है ना. सो अगर डीएम बाई डी पी, ये मैंने स्मॉल में लिखे है यहाँ पे, तो यहाँ पे ये कैपिटल है, तो इसको भी स्मॉल कर देना, नहीं तो गड़बड़ हो जाएगा. तो डीएम बाई डी पी इफ इट इज 1/5, रो पी इज नोन टू यू, म्यू पी इज नोन टू यू. नाउ म्यू बाई रो, दैट इज काइनेमेटिक विस्कोसिटी, म्यू एम by rho m. Mu by rho is nothing but kinematic viscosity of m. M means a model. Model means a water. Model mein water flow ho raha hai. So kinematic of viscosity of water diya hua hai, 10^-6 meter square per second diya hua hai problem mein. To yahan se tumhe mil jayega ke ye mu m by rho m ka value mil gaya. Theek hai. क्योंकि काइनेमेटिक विस्कोसिटी मतलब ही है म्यू बाई रो. तो ये सभी इंफॉर्मेशन यहाँ पे पुट कर दो, तो यहाँ से तुम्हें मिल जाएगा वी एम का वैल्यू मिल जाएगा. दैट मीन्स वेलोसिटी ऑफ द मॉडल फ्लूइड, वेलोसिटी ऑफ द मॉडल फ्लूइड, दैट मीन्स द वाटर, इट विल कमिंग विथ 6 मीटर पर सेकेंड, बिकॉज रेस्ट ऑफ द ऑल पैरामीटर्स आर नोन टू अस. दिस विल बी द आंसर ऑफ ए, गॉट इट. Then I am removing this top part. It will be not needed for you now. This part obviously you have to do and reply to me, is it right or not. Then coming to the B part. B part mein basically bola gaya hai ke what is the ratio of the quantities of flow in prototype or model. So the quantities of flow means QP by QM, that is a discharge. And QP by QM is nothing but, I can write it like this, Vp into AP by Vam into AM, isn't it? Discharge means area into velocity, nothing but that. So I can write it like this way, Vp into area को हम लोग length square में लिख सकते हैं, LP square, और ऐसे ही इसको भी ऐसे ही A length square में लिख सकते हैं. क्यों लिखे? क्योंकि length ratio हमें पता है, that's why I am writing this panel. So velocity of the paraffin, it is known to us now, 3 meter per second, and velocity of model fluid, that is also known to us, 6 meter per second, and LP by LM, that is also known to us, LM by LP or LP by MM, LM, that will be 5. So put all those values over there and get the ratio, it will be giving you 12.5, that means 12.5:1. So discharge of the prototype will be 12.5 times than the discharge of model. Very easy. Then coming to the part C. C part mein bola gaya hai ki find the pressure drop in prototype if it is model in a 60 kPa. Okay. So in this particular case, use the pi 1 relationship. Pi 1 model and pi 1 prototype. क्यों? क्योंकि इसमें, इस रिलेशनशिप में तुम्हें मिल जाएगा प्रेशर. ये रिलेशनशिप ऐसा बना था पाई वन का, डेल पी डी बाय म्यू इनटू वी फॉर मॉडल इक्वल्स टू
del P D mu into V that are for prototype. Now that del P you have to find for the prototype. That means del P for the prototype you have to find out. And del P M, that is model for it is given, that is 60 kPa, it is given to you. And dm by dp, it is also known to us, dm by dp is 1 by 5. Mu m, that is the viscosity of the model, that means the water. Okay, that you have to find out because kinematic viscosity is known to you. Nu m, that means kinematic viscosity, it is 10 to the power minus 6 meter square per second. ये दिया हुआ है वाटर का और डेंसिटी ऑफ वाटर इज ऑल्सो नोन टू यू 1000 केजी पर मीटर क्यूब इट इज ऑलरेडी नोन टू अस फ्रॉम आवर चाइल्डहुड नॉलेज सो फ्रॉम देयर फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ म्यू एम दैट मीन्स द फ्लूइड ऑफ द मॉडल सो म्यू एम फ्रॉम हियर इट विल बी नोन टू यू डीएम बाय डीपी इट इज ऑल्सो नोन टू यू वीएम दैट मीन्स द 6 मीटर पर सेकेंड VP that is already known to us 3 meter per second so that way only the term whatever it is known unknown to you that is del P of P that means differential pressure or pressure drop in case of prototype and it will be coming 12 kPa because del P model is given that is 60 kPa so kPa that del P model mu m vm DM, this whole part, DM is not known to you, but DM by DP is known to you, because DM by DP, from here you can see that DM by DP is nothing but 1 by 5, because it is a scale ratio. VM is known 6 meter per second. So these values will be help you to find the differential pressure. Understood? So that way you can complete the whole problem just like a simple analytical solution. It's not a very critical problem, I think. Just you have to do the dimensional analysis using Buckingham Pi theorem. Build the dimensionless functions pi 1, pi 2, pi 3. Then using those similarities, you can find all of these very easily. If you have any kind of confusion regarding this problem, then please comment on to it. I will again come back with you.